Man, scene was so thick. Low riders, 77 Sevilles, L Dogs, nothing but them blacks. All the players, all the hustlers. I'm talking about a black man heaven here. You know what I'm saying?
My name is Rico Wade, one third of Organized Noize Production. 113th, I guess, of Dungeon Family. This is Stankonia Studio, which was Boss Town back when we first recorded Outkast's first album and TLC's Waterfalls and some of our first works, but now it's the home of Outkast, Stankonia.
Absolutely. Ray Murray, the second third of ONP. This is where the magic happens.
Pairs Ball was the first single that blew up, that really took off for us. You know what I mean? Outkast first single. We did look at like our first opportunity to let the world know what we can do. So that's why I think creatively, you got Sleepy singing the hook. Got the production, boom, 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 boom. Like, it went about, it's about like.
You got the break with the live phase.
Yeah. It was like, let's come with it.
That was the scary part too, about that, because you know what I'm saying?
We didn't want to come across
too. Didn't want it to be too musical, being on the face records.
And that's why we didn't use a live bass through the song.
Absolutely.
It was just, the live bass was just at the end, just to show you. We know the funk or whatever, but it was very important that bass line. You can go listen to Players Ball right now. So we felt like the more analog sounds we could actually use, the more real Rhodes, World of Service, B3 organs, the more that kind of stuff we used, we felt like was going to make the production more analog or whatever. And I think that was our theory, and that's why Richard. And I think that's what helped. We felt like at that time, being very honest, DJ Quick. We've heard these records, Born and Raised, and Compton, and we liked it. We heard the records in New York, like Brooklyn, and we liked it. So we felt like other people did too. We was like, okay, if we can get Atlanta accepted without pushing it, like Atlanta records come out with ATLA, not as quick as that, but like. If we could, it's okay to show some pride. If we represent it, Southern playlist and Cadillac music. You know what I'm saying? That verse, the way he used his Southern lingo, and the way he was articulate, and the way he had the kind of high voice or whatever, Get Up, Get Out wasn't a verse, it was a song. And our whole thing with Dungeon Family was that make your next move your best move. If you got something hot and we about to put an album out, let's not hold it, wait for that next album. It's implemented on this album. Cool Breeze gave Goody Mob Dirty South. You know what I'm saying? CeeLo gave Outkast Get Up, Get Out. I don't recall ever graduating at all. Sometimes I feel I'm just a disappointment to y'all. Every day I just stay around and I can't be found. Always asking, give me some, living life like a bronze.
Earthling. From the bottom of my lungs, a nigga be blowing, spitting his game. Coming up on you from the top, the ATLians ain't changed. Cooler than most.
Two dope boys in the Cadillac was made in this room. I actually put the vocals down in this room. But I guess I just gotta be honest. It was just a good day, a good digging. It was a good day digging in the crates. Cause that was one of the ones, we don't do that. We don't do that.
That was the third.
We don't do that. We don't really do that. Just say we're gonna just hear some.
Just put a beat on a sample.
And it was like the five steps was like one. Obviously, it was like, let's go and give it to him, man. Let's give it to him just like this. We've earned it. We've been paying for those samples. We ain't gotta pay for those samples. We heard it, man. Let's go ahead and clear it. It's clear, man. It's clear. And we put the little, it's just two dope boys. And I just got Peaches, just took her voice, like again. Just really was on some real, how can I say, when you're confident in what you're doing now, We got this. People don't even notice, but if you go to their shows, it's a whole different mix that a whole other engineer did that we use. That's wilder. That sounds ghetto. That's booming. So it rock or whatever. But for the album, the vocals sounded everywhere. To where Neil vocals was right in your face and they were warm. And that was important too, because we were working with LA Babyface and the kind of people that they had around doing records. So that's something else too that has something to do with our record. Those things, these NS10s right here was important. It wasn't just about, but it was like, they would sit right here in the face and make sure the vocals, can you feel it? Can you feel the vocal? Can you, the mood of it, is nothing sticking out or whatever? Like we would talk all these things, like that's the school of the face they say. Like the beat was done originally, with two Dope Boyz, the beat was done originally, but it set the tone of the album. Like this is the vibe. This the vibe, but we end up doing the whole album before they end up doing the song. Like the hook might have been put on it, but it was just like, oh, this is gonna be the intro. We're gonna do it. It was the vibe. It was dope. But it was just a sample, and the guys were already more advanced than just that. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? We were already into like being intrigued by more music. You see how elevators, we had the little moody sound and little sound up under it, whatever, like. What inspires you to write great stuff is the music. And Elevators, and Two Dope Boyz was just a loop or whatever. But it was so cool. It was Wu-Tang-ish. It was Wu-Tang-ish. And we knew that. You know what I'm saying? But it was still Southern. It had that cool, like some cool shit that was on that 36 Chambers album.
Because nobody in the South has done
that like that. So we felt like we had opened up that gateway to where now
we can do anything.
Yes, we could bridge this gap.
Yeah.
We accept it a little bit. You know what I'm saying? So let's keep it a little more real. Let's not be Weird Al, and so let's not be some of these guys just trying to do it. Like let's push it forward.
The magic about if there is magic in that song, in the song that I skewed on the Barbie, it is the swing of the SP-1200, which is why New York might really love it. You know what I mean? Because it does, you know, the SP-1200 has a certain kind of rhythm to it that is different than every other drum machine. You know what I mean? It's a clunkiness. That clunkiness turns into, it's a real square type of rhythm. It's real bot-dot-ish. You feel me? That turns into its own kind of swing. You feel me? So to program on it, yeah, it's naturally, that's built into it, damn near. That space, you know what I mean? So when we did that song, that was just the vibe, you know what I mean? I couldn't tell you that it was a New York vibe. It was an East Coast vibe. It just was a pushing vibe. The 1200, actually, after we did Get Up, Get Out, and Waterfalls, you know, these kinds of things with SP-12, well, let's just push it. And we pushed it, you feel me?
Yeah, and then just a tidbit, we was in Doppler Studios, Erykah Badu had walked in, and I remember she was the one who was like, that's it right there. She was the one. Ray had just hit, whatever that bionic woman, whatever that little loop was, whatever thing you was doing.
Policewoman.
And she was like,
The theme from Policewoman is the sample.
Yes, that's what made.
Is what the song is based on.
That's what made them say, play it again. It was just going. Like, so that's when they said they wanted to be their song. Then, like I said, the Raekwon part came when Wu-Tang had opened up the Wu store. Wu-Tang opened up the Wu store down here in Atlanta, and Power reached out. The big boy reached out to us and was just like, you know, Ray want to do something with you guys. Like, he's letting you know he's available. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's up? We want to do some stuff with. Whoa, okay. That's what happened. It was like, what y'all think about getting him on that one? That was it. Andre had him busted open. Like big, it was like, that was it. Raekwon wanted to get on one. Man, it was such a, cause I gotta feel like they reached out to us, and it was such a great look, you know what I'm saying? Such a great look for Ray, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? Like, as far as him, he killed it, but it's what pushed Outkast over the top on that album to get to 5 mic. It made New York feel good about giving us certain accolades because we was more one of them and not somebody trying to like act like that we're the hip hop. Oh, hip hop is down here. No, like we learn from y'all. Like we learn from y'all. We trying to keep this going. Old school players, new school fools. Cats keep it jumping like kangaroos. Yes, Andre put the first verse. Andre put the first verse. And then Raekwon, then Big Boy. That's why he got the breakdown. We the type of boy that like the break. It was almost like he got all the tricks, he got all the gadgets because it was already going down. And Raekwon went crazy, didn't he?
Hydro. But it's about that hi-hat on that song.
Yeah, man. That snare too, man. That snare.
Well, it snapped back.
The snare.
But that.
You can't, dude, that's legendary. Old school player. That's out of here.
That's what it was.
That's out of here. That's one of them shining moments. Everybody was just, because it was such a treat. It was such a treat. It was like Raekwon came out. As an Outkast fan, Raekwon, Skew and Barbie. So Fresh, So Clean, Uncut. I'm gonna say this.
First, we did not hear this Joe Simon, is that who it is, Joe Simon's record? We've never heard of this song.
Yeah.
We had never played the vinyl, we never heard the CD. I never even knew about it being in existence until after we did our song. And then somebody said, hey, here's the sample you sampled.
Yeah, I was like, nah.
What?
Sleepy taught me a lot too, or whatever. Like, and that was one of them days when I was listening to him. Like, he came over, was like, hey, Reed, man, check this little vibe out. Do 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 do. But he was just playing around with it. He was just kind of like his vibe. He was like humming and hitting. I was like,
on the roads.
Yeah, on the roads. He was just hitting the roads and humming, and he was like, I was like, I like that. He said, all right, do something with it, man. Then he left. The next day he came back, but he left like 6 or 7. Like, came about 4 or 5, left about 6 or 7. So about 9 or 10, it's locked in my mind. I'm thinking about it. But I ain't did that with it, but I'm thinking about it to where I'm gathering sounds. I'm just thinking like, trying to think of what, because he wanted me to come up with some words. Like, come up with some words for this. Come up with some words. When he said about it, come up with some, you know, some lyrics or something. And next thing you know, the next day come, I get up, get in the shower. That melody is in my mind. Cause that's what Sleepy brings now. Like, he brings live instrumentation, music. So I'm just, boom, boom, ka, boom, 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 ka, boom, boom. Like, I'm in the shower and I'm actually hearing, boom, boom, ka, boom, 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 ka, boom, 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 ka, boom, 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 ka, boom, boom, ka, boom, to where, like, I almost ran out of butt naked. I was like, oh man! And like in my mind, the way the beat was coming, I was thinking like, this is not nobody's beat. Like, this ain't nobody's beat. This ain't like the bridge is over. This is, I'm really just following the melody. But these kicks are falling into places to where it's not overlapping. It's not. It's like it's a snare free. It's almost like this is a cool loop. So I go right downstairs and program the whole thing all the way out. And couldn't wait for him to come back over. He came over the day, came over that same day, by 4 or 5. I said, hey, what's that little thing you trying to play, you sing? He said, yeah, I'll play it. As soon as he hit it, he said, he started laying into it a little more then, like, okay, good. Like, literally, I remember feeling like, great. So I asked him something. I said, you mind putting it down? And then I got the beat pattern, so we recorded it. I said, why don't you sing the melody to it without no words? Because I'm supposed to come up with words now. But now we're just getting the process going. So, next day, get up, same thing. I get in the shower, and I'm thinking about the vibe, the way he was singing a little do 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 do. Now I'm in the shower, the whole so fresh and so clean. I'm like, oh. I'm in the shower. I swear. I'm in the shower like, hey, no, man, he's still past me. Because I'm really, we in a comfortable place. Sleepy could, he was so comfortable with just being like, whatever the vibe, like he'll spill it. It's the vibe. Da-da-da-da. It's up to you now to like, and he gonna just accept anything. And you're not gonna accept anything. But when you catch it, that's it right there. Big boy. General Patton, like shoes to a slipper, like listen to his verses. That was his baby. Because at this point, Big Boy and Andre are winning. They did Bombs Over Baghdad. They did Miss Jackson. They got the album, like these are, L.A. Reid is flipping. He's shooting a Gary Gray video to Miss Jackson. We gonna shoot a video with just animals and we're going for the Grammys for this one. Like he knew what he was like, we going for it. And I'm gonna shoot them, let them run through the projects with Bombs Over. Like we were letting everybody got a chance to let their nuts hang on that one. Andre wanted that Bombs Over Baghdad video. L.A. Reid wanted that Miss Jackson. And we wanted So Fresh, So Clean. But we couldn't just get what we wanted. We earned it. And Andre decided to come to the party toward the end. He decided, he was like, but when he came, he was ready. He said, I mean, he killed it. He said, we are the coolest motherfuckers on the planet.